Hello dear students, in the last lecture of microbiology part first, we have already started with the structure and function of the different organs present in the bacterial cell. So in the previous lecture we have already seen that a bacterial cell under an electron microscope reveals many components, some of which are external to the cell wall and some are internal to the cell wall. Some of the structures are confined only to the certain species, and some other structures which acts as a characteristic features of the certain species. The parts which we have studied earlier are the structures which are present externally to the cell wall of bacteria, which includes flagella, capsule and sheaths, pili and fimbriae. And in our today's lecture, we are going to study the cell wall of bacterial cell. Now, a cell wall is a very rigid structure which provides support and gives shape to the cell. Cell wall ka important role kya hota hai ki wo kya karta hai? Kisi bhi cell ko ek rigid shape provide karne ka kaam cell wall karta hai. It is about 100 to 150 nanometers in thickness, and in most of the bacteria which lives in the hypotonic environment and tends to take up water due to the variations in the osmotic pressure between the bacterial cell in the existing environment. जो भी बैक्टीरिया हाइपोटोनिक एरियाज में ग्रो होते हैं, जहाँ की सॉल्टी एनवायरनमेंट या फिर अल्कलाइन कंडीशंस जहाँ प्रेजेंट होते हैं, ऐसे कंडीशंस में प्रेजेंट माइक्रोबियल सेल्स में सेल वॉल की थिकनेस ज़्यादा होती है. इट इज़ अराउंड 100 टू 140 नैनोमीटर्स. Hence, the main function of the cell wall is to prevent the cell from expanding and eventually bursting in those hypotonic environment. ऐसे environment में जहाँ osmotic pressure ज़्यादा develop होता है due to alkaline conditions, तो osmotic pressure की वजह से here the water supply from the outside environment is continuously carried out from the environment to inside the bacterial cell, and there is the chances of bursting of the cell wall of bacteria. So these thickness of the cell wall prevents the bacteria from the outer environment, and these cell wall, it remains beneath the capsule. Means the capsule, in the last lecture we have already seen that the capsule is the outermost layer of the bacterial cell, and beneath it or below it, the layer which is present, it is known as cell wall. Now we will see some of the functions of bacterial cell wall. Now the main function of the bacterial cell wall is to provide overall strength to the cell. As we have seen earlier, bacteria ki cell jo hoti hai wo rigid hoti hai, uski thickness bhi zyada hoti hai, to wo kya karta hai, usko particular strength provide karne ka kaam cell wall karta hai. And it also helps to maintain the cell shape, thereby helping the cell to grow, reproduce, obtain nutrients and also carry out the process of locomotion. यहाँ सेल को प्रॉपर शेप प्रोवाइड करने का काम या फिर उसकी ग्रोथ रिप्रोडक्शन में हेल्प करने का काम सेल वॉल करती है. देन सेल वॉल ऑल्सो प्रोटेक्ट्स द सेल फ्रॉम द ऑस्मेटिक लाइसिस. हमने पहले भी देखा कि हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन होगा या फिर हाइपोटोनिक एनवायरनमेंट होगा, तो ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर की वजह से सेल का ब्रेकडाउन होने का जो चांस होता है या फिर रिस्क होती है, वो रिस्क भी रिड्यूस करने का काम कौन करता है? सेल वॉल करता है. देन इट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स the cell to keep out certain molecules which may be toxic. Cell wall क्या करता है, जो भी toxic molecules present होते हैं, the entry of those toxic material inside the cell is prevented with the help of cell wall. Then the bacterial cell wall also contributes to the pathogenicity. In the other words, means disease causing ability of bacterial cell is caused due to the presence of cell wall. These was all the functions of bacterial cell wall. Then we will see the structure and chemical composition of bacterial cell wall. Now what are the chemical composition of the bacterial cell wall? The bacterial cell wall generally consists of different layers like peptidoglycan, lipopolysaccharides and other different types of chemicals. And this cell wall is composed of two polymers. One consists of saccharide subunit and other consists of amino acid subunits. Saccharides means sugar molecules and amino acids. In dono ko milakar, in dono polymers ko एक साथ लाकर हमारी सेल वॉल बनती है. एंड दस द बैक्टीरियल सेल वॉल इज ग्लाइकोपेप्टाइड विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज योर पॉलीपेप्टाइड लेयर. ओके, एंड दीज पॉलीपेप्टाइड आर इनसोल्यूबल पोरस in nature which are linked with the help of different polymers. Generally if we consider the prokaryotic cell, in prokaryotic cell this polypeptide layer is quite rigid. And it has the bag-like shaped structure. मतलब जैसे हमारी कोई बैग होती है, बैग में हम हमारे जो भी मटेरियल होता है वो मटेरियल हम उसमें क्या करते हैं, स्टोर करते हैं. एंड दैट बैग हेल्प्स टू प्रोवाइड द प्रोटेक्शन टू द मटेरियल विच इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड इट. सेम वे द बैग लाइक शेप ऑफ आर सेल वॉल प्रिवेंट्स द इनर ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द सेल. The saccharide component of the cell wall has alternating repeating units of the amino sugars related to the glucose. One of these two is your NAM, which is NAM, N-acetylglucosamine. Here you can see it is N-acetylglucosamine, and the other is NAG, which is NAG, which stands for N-acetyl glucosamine. And both these NAG and NAM forms a backbone of the cell wall structure. And then there are again four amino acids that composes the tetrapeptides. For example, L-alanine, D-glutamine, D-amino acids, and also D-alanine in gram-positive bacteria and actinomycetes. Actinomycetes or gram-positive bacteria mein ye char type ke amino acids present hote hai. Which provides a particular structure to the cell wall. If we consider about cell wall of archaebacteria, in archaebacteria the peptide layer is not present, as well as cell wall and the chemical composition of the cell wall is slightly different than the eukaryotic cell. And it is made up of proteins, glycoproteins, polysaccharides, etc. This was all about the chemical composition, structure, and function of the cell wall. Now, depending on these chemical composition, the bacteria is classified in two groups. One is your gram-positive bacteria and other one is your gram-negative bacteria. Now, how does these bacteria are differentiated in two groups depending on the cell wall composition, that we will study in our next lecture. Thank you.